Penguin Random House Audio presents Liferider, Heart, Body, Soul, and Life Beyond the Ocean by Laird Hamilton with Julian Borra. Read for you by Elijah Allan-Blitz, Gabrielle Reece, and Julian Borra.
Introduction. It would be very easy to dismiss Laird Hamilton. Many have, and still do. Controversial, incorrigible, radical, visionary, revolutionary, disrespectful, disobedient, unpredictable, a dick. Laird's emphatic statement that he would take every wave and don't get in my way, big dogs eat first, set him up as a potentially extraordinary, yet fairly unpleasant, growing master of his art. Playing Lance Burkhart in the seminal 80s surf movie, North Shore, didn't exactly help his burgeoning reputation as a bad boy. Even positive comments, as celebratory as they are, seem to be in some ways still intent on putting him back in a box. There are many people who view Laird Hamilton as a force of nature. His last book was titled exactly that. Whether Laird's tongue was at this point firmly in his own or someone else's cheek is not clear. Laird is surprisingly humble about himself. But for many people, when they watch a YouTube clip or look at a magazine spread or hear a podcast, they simply see and hear a slightly folksy, big wave culture, a lifestyle of fitness routines and superfoods, and a surfer narcissism of wave first always. This is to some extent understandable. The internet is teeming with Lairdness and Lairdisms. Laird's aphorisms are everywhere. But there's a lot more to Laird than meets the eye. And to dismiss him as mostly irrelevant to us land-based folk, or to park him as some type of Peter Pan figure, is to miss something. In some ways, Laird is like the waves he rides, seemingly simple, yet intriguingly complex. Liferider is a small journey into that. Liferider is Laird's view from the lip of life, observations from where he is right now on how we might better manage the turbulence of life, the biggest wave we'll ever ride, by reaching back into the brilliant creature we are, instead of always reaching up to the being we aspire to be. If force of nature captured Laird, the He Nalu, the wave slider, by skimming across the surface and the sheen of the lifestyle of one of the world's greatest big wave surfers, Liferider is the foil that taps into the energy inside his wave, to reach a little deeper and range a little wider through the brilliant creature that is Laird Hamilton. Brilliant creature is not a grand title only to be applied to a celebrity surfer. It is the Liferider term for who and what we are at our best. Laird believes we're all brilliant creatures, and that we have only just started to tap into the amazing human organism that we are. When you strip everything back, down to the most basic elements of our species, we as humans can draw on an extraordinarily sophisticated and delicately calibrated combination of physicality, intelligence, emotion, and intuition, at both the conscious and the unconscious level. Our human consciousness lights us up in a way no other species comes close to matching. In talks with schoolchildren, Laird inspires them to take a closer, harder look at the brilliant creatures that they are.
You can run, swim, dive, fly. You are amazing. You have untapped potential in you that would blow your mind. Laird Hamilton.
In this also lies one of the truths of Liferider. While the world increasingly seeks happiness in memes and self-help books, millions of us reaching upward every day towards some enlightened being that we wish to be, Laird is more intent on inspiring us to reach back into the primal organism, the brilliant creature we are, to unlock those doors, throw some of those genetic switches, and mine more of ourselves for ourselves. Liferider is not against enlightenment. It simply seeks to inspire us to be the best and most brilliant creature that we can be, seen through the lens of Laird, starting with the physical organism. The simple premise of Liferider is this: start with the groundwork. Be the best or fittest organism you can be. Build the best foundation you can from which to then pursue whatever enlightenment or elevation you might desire. And movement is a keystone of that foundation. Call it exercise, call it keeping fit, call it evolution. Call it getting off your ass and doing something. Call it whatever you like. but movement is a crucial part of that groundwork. In order to think, we need to move. We are built for movement. Movement defines us as creatures. When we forget to move, we lose momentum. We forget our most basic selves. When our thinking starts to overwhelm our doing, that is not always a good thing. Less thinking, more doing. That is how we evolve and continue to grow. This means movement of every kind: physical, intellectual, emotional, and spiritual. In the words of the galactic funkster George Clinton and his seminal funk rock troupe Parliament Funkadelic, free your mind and your ass will follow. Our minds are so consumed these days. We're busy, 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 busy. And we're feeding our brains a tsunami of stimulus every day. We are screenagers, hopping from device to device, consuming the all-you-can-eat bite-sized buffet of social networks and the connected self. Technology has created in us a new layer of digital consciousness that enhances and amplifies almost every aspect of our lives. But to a certain degree, we're becoming trapped by it. It has become another barrier between ourselves and the brilliant creatures we are. As we have developed as a species, we have always put up barriers between ourselves and the natural world in which we have evolved. Shelters, walls, windows, roofs, heat. Each layer, a new man-made skin. Staggering invention and innovation have made us the preeminent creature on the planet. And over the most recent millennia, our minds have gone into overdrive, using the technologies of language, mechanics, engineering, printing, still and moving pictures, telecommunication, and now digital platforms, networks, and artificial intelligence to propagate the memes of human evolution, and in the process, sharing and spreading the word on how to be better and more civilized. What about mindfulness? Technological progress has allowed us to surge forward as a species, but it also makes us lazy. We have used technology to move ourselves from a short life of incredible hardship to one that is far longer and now allows for increasing luxury. And with luxury comes pleasure and subsequently inertia. We're using technology to find the path of least resistance, increasingly seeking a frictionless world. But friction and resistance are human needs. They are how we evolve. We thrive on them, and we need to keep them alive in us. Laird is committed to creating friction, putting the organism under duress. Gabby Reece, his wife, goes further. She believes that Laird not only needs friction to exist, she would say he is friction. That is what he brings to the world around him. Every aspect of their XPT, Extreme Performance Training course, focuses on stressing the physical, the mental, and the spiritual in every participant, taking them beyond. That's what Laird does. He has spent a lifetime reaching beyond himself, beyond what is, starting with his physicality. Laird has a roadmap of injuries that plot his time on the planet doing what he does, stressing the organism, pushing it beyond what it might seem capable of. And one thing that he will share with anyone interested enough to ask is that at the heart of that is movement. Movement of our body, our mind, our emotions, shapes how we live. Movement also shapes how we heal. We heal faster when we move. Even when every fiber in us is saying, please don't, it hurts, healing through movement is engineered into us. When risk and danger existed all around us, inertia was not an option. So we have evolved the ability to heal while we move, because to not move once meant death. And if we are engineered to do nothing else, we are engineered to survive. This is the gene pool imperative. Survive, stay alive, for as long as possible, to multiply the gene pool as often as possible. All of our nurture mechanisms, and so many of all our capabilities, initially stem from the organism's desire to stay alive. Millennia before our enlightened age set in, millions of years were spent honing the organism in the natural world to survive. Liferider is an invitation to free your mind from itself and from the all-consuming information age, even if just for a few hours a week, and move your proverbial ass, in any direction, in any way, to any degree, but move it nonetheless. Natural intelligence. Liferider has no interest in dismissing the advances of human existence. Technology as we currently know it is an amazing thing. Social networks and hyperconnectivity are transforming human existence.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.